Okay, so
my kind of wrestling, it's always evolving, right?
And when you start to kind of figure things out in the sense of what you are giving up, what you are allowing him to do, taking advantage of his own position, you'll start to kind of tinker and play and be like, wow, that was easy. Because you're actually using that man's body, positioning to benefit everything you want to do. Right? So some of it comes across as wrong. Now, I was taught inside control, right? Collar tied, you're on inside. Well, that's all great. It all works. Yes, it does. So I started playing around with, in high school and college, and then, internationally. When a guy collar tied me, instead of fighting back inside, I would re-collar right over the top. Now, I know that that's a no-no, right? You're not supposed to do that. Well, it made for such an easy snap because he felt secure, right? So if a guy collar ties me, we're here, guy with collar tie, instead of coming back inside, I come right over the top and re-collar tie this man, right? Now, yes, I know, good leg. Right? I'm giving up my leg. Yeah, I got it. But what I would do to prevent that, I would pinch right here. I'd try and capture his hand in between my neck and my shoulder. So if I felt that hand slipping, you better believe my leg's coming back. Right? Now, this made for an easy snap. Reason being is, because when that guy has your head, you're kind of giving him a ledge to hold on to. You're actually keeping your head up. You want him, the more you try to take something away, the more he wants it, right? So, if I just put my head down, he's just gonna stuff my head towards that mat. He's actually not holding on to it, he's just pushing. But if I keep my head up here and it gives him something to hold on to, he actually kind of hangs on it a little bit. I'm actually gonna let him do that. And I'm coming over the top. Now, key thing, I do not want to be here with a straight arm. I am here, bent arm, and I'm actually gonna pull his head, from forehead to forehead, I'm gonna pull his head towards his arm, and I'm gonna be looking into his ear. Now, we're not ear to ear, I'm looking into his ear here. My elbow is pointing towards that mat. All right, now, I keep my head up the entire time. This snap is all in your waist. I'm gonna circle, I take a little step. Now, I'm going to bend at my waist. I'm gonna keep my head up. I'm gonna keep him holding onto my head, onto my head, onto my head, till the very end. I dip my head down and I pull towards the mat. Right towards the mat, okay? So, that guy collar ties, I come back over the top. Now, I'm still protecting here. I have my back hand for a cross block if he goes to shoot. So I still feel okay. But I have that collar, I pinch, and I pull his head towards his arm. And I get my head, and I'm looking into that ear. All right? Now, I'm gonna take a little step. I'm gonna bend at my waist, keep my head up, and at the last second, bend at my waist, I'm gonna dip my head, pull towards the mat. Circle, bend, 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 bend. Now I dip my head, my chin, and my chest, and I pull towards the mat. He will come off. Okay? So, that's the last kind of snap to pick yourself out. All right, one more time. We're here, we're pinching, I'm looking down that ear, I circle, dip it right off, right to my short off. Okay? Now, for the last one, this is my absolute favorite, because when you get it, it's like, that was so easy. So, I love front headlock. I love short offense. Now, our guys, we teach our guys. You're in here, you attack that chin hand. You break his fingers if you have. You do not let him get your chin. Now, if I feel that, I don't want to lose my front headlock. And if I let him stay on my hand, I'm going to lose it. He's going to get out. So, I'm going to pull it out. I'm going to pull it out, and I'm going to go to hooks. I like to call them, T-Rex arms here. So, I have my front headlock.